as a band, what are some of your biggest influences?
I'd say vocally, at least I can speak for vocals. Vocally, I'd say there's definitely a Neil Young influence. Some more soul, like Otis Redding, something like that. Guitar-wise, I mean, there's definitely an influence on the music. It's definitely coming from Middle Eastern, kind of Mediterranean vibe. We kind of grew up, or at least a few of us grew up listening to that at home. A little bit of Spanish influence as well.
Yeah, on the my playing's a lot of jazz rock stuff. Superstition, things like Stevie Wonder, Al Di Meola, and some Mars Volta, and things like that.
What kind of show do you guys put on?
Nothing you've ever seen before.
Most extravagant traveler show in the world.
Yeah, it's you won't even know what to do with yourself. It's mind-boggling music.
No, it's good. It's a nice mix of easy listening. You know, it's not too heavy, not too not too soft. It's got sax, beautiful new age stuff,
and yeah. You know, some heart in the background.
Very clear.
What's your favorite aspect of living and performing in Brooklyn?
The community that we're in, the people, the different influences, the different kind of different media I think that people use is very kind of unifies or makes Brooklyn unique as opposed to other places that seem to be more genre specific. There seems to be a lot of different things going on here, a lot of musically, a lot of, you know, just a lot of, it's young. It's developing, it's constantly moving forward.
Yeah, I actually think that's pretty spot on, the Brooklyn thing. Playing Manhattan is definitely different. It's more, it feels more competitive, and in Brooklyn you just kind of like, you're more amongst friends and everyone's kind of supporting each other. You know most of the people that you're playing with, and it's...
I feel like people know each other more in Brooklyn.
Yeah.
It's more of a communal.
Absolutely. Yeah. And it's usually more exciting. I'm not going to say that necessarily, but it's more inspired music. You know, generally, I find a lot of music I tend to run into in Manhattan. It's like, you know, in terms of rock bands and, you know, pop bands and things, they're a little
formulated.
Tribe and formulated. Like, Brooklyn has some this cool sound going on, a lot of different sounds. Mm.
Do you guys have any albums that you're recording? Are you recording anything in the studio right now, or are you just playing live shows?
We're about to, in about a week or two, get into the studio and record this more collaborative EP. I wouldn't call it second, but it's more of the first real collaborative EP with all of us.
Can you talk a little bit about it?
Sure. The content of the songs? Or the...
We're calling it Human Tripods, right?
Yeah.
The first EP was more of Yagil's full songs that he had. Speak more to that, but the sound was even more like folky, a little lighter. Now that we've all been kind of rocking out together, it's progressed to a little bit more of a slightly more rock and roll type thing.
A little more progressive, a little more, a little more eclectic. The original EP is eclectic as well, but this time Gil is kind of calling on everybody to contribute. So it is. It's come out a. A little more out there, a little more eclectic, like I said, and maybe a little groovy too. Yeah, but we're just trying to cater to a large mass amount of people without, you know, being too poppy or too mainstream, which is a good thing, because it's hard to find, you know, music that everybody likes that is not formulaic.
Yeah, I think one thing that separates our music from a lot of what you hear today is it's it comes from a really honest place. There's a lot of bands today that listen to the latest thing and want to sound like the latest band, the Arcade Fire, Edward Sharpe, whatever it is, and are derivative of that. But the one thing I love about this music is that it's really honest. I don't think we're trying to be hip. We're just kind of playing our song and we're doing it pretty well. So it's one thing I really like about this. We're not really trying too hard.
a very, I mean, I can't say we're not trying to, yeah.
And that's
to
the
be
same
cool,
time.
We're not trying hard
yeah,
to, like,
no.
appeal to anyone.
Yeah,
we're not,
I think
you know,
so
it's all organic, yeah. We're not ever saying, oh, we want to write a song that sounds like this band, or, you know,
yeah.
take this type of thing. I mean, like I said, I don't even like music, you know.
Yeah.
I mean, yeah, that's kind of true. I kind of hooked up with these guys through Craigslist. Of all things, but you know, they like bands usually have this. They give you their website. You can listen to all their music. And I was going through a bunch of them, and sort of what Chris was saying, it wasn't really inspired. It was kind of just like what every other band out there, pretty much. You know, you could find copies and copies of these people you hear. These guys were kind of. It sounded different. It sounded unique. And, genuine, really genuine sort of stuff. So.
Thanks.
Yeah, at least from the yeah, thanks. First time. At least the writing I can speak about this upcoming EP that it is all very personal stuff. They all come from very personal experiences of, you know, either getting stuck on the side of the road or meditating in the subway or, you know, whatever the song is, but They never come from sitting around and forcing myself to write a song. They always just come naturally, you know, just this, you know, this drive to just, I have to get this out somehow, and, you know, they always feel personal, you know, and I think that's, you know, that's also what they're trying to say, that everyone now is able to give a part of themselves into the songs, and I feel everyone feels like the songs are ours, not, as opposed to the first EP, just, you know, my songs that they're playing or something like that, you know.
We're playing the Hoover Dam Collective at the residency show on February 5th. We are going on at 10:30, and we'd love to see you there.
Check it out.
Yes.
We're not going on at 10:30.
No.
You will see when we go on once you get there.
Come to the show at 8 p.m.